Hello students, good morning. After a long time, we are back again. We have to continue the lesson, the French Revolution. Here, we have finished till the outbreak of the revolution. In that, we have discussed last presentation, we had discussed about the meeting which Louis XVI had conducted in his palace, which consisted of the first estate, second estate, and third estate. And in third estates were more members were there. First and second estates, less members were there. But first and second estate, they have got the seats. But the third estate had to stand for that meeting behind. So this was much insulting for the third estate. And other than that, this meeting which was conducted, many members, 300 representatives from third estates were there present. So this we had finished in the last presentation. Today we have to study that the third estate representatives, they walked out of the assembly hall or out of the assembly in protest. Because first I have told you that they were standing behind. More than that, these representatives, they had demanded many things. But their demands were not taken into consideration by Louis XVI. So that meeting was not a democratic meeting. The third estate representatives demanded Louis XVI that each member would have one vote. So they had asked the Louis XVI that each member of the third of that assembly hall, they must have each vote or one vote for everyone. And before that, the estate general or the meeting, estate general, which we can say the meeting. These meetings which had conducted by Louis XVI or his ancestors, the system was that each estate had one vote, not each representative. So the same system Louis XVI had followed. That means each estate had one vote. So here Louis XVI arranged the same thing of voting, that is each estate had one vote, but the third estate representatives demanded this system, against this system, and they demanded for each member would have one vote. But Louis XVI did not agree with that. The third estate representative got these ideas from Rousseau's, the philosopher known as Rousseau. He had written the book, The Social Contract. And the social contract, these ideas were included in social contract. So the third estate got these ideas from this book and they asked to Louis XVI to give one vote for every each member, each vote. Each member should have one vote. The third estate representatives viewed themselves as the spokesmen for the whole French nation because they were more in member and they were standing for whole French nation, they were standing for the demands. And Louis XVI did not agree with this, and that is why the third estate representatives walked out of the assembly hall in protest. Now let's see. The next thing which happened, that is on 20th June. So the representatives of third estate, they walked out from the hall or from the palace. They met in another important hall which was known as a tennis court or an indoor tennis court in Versailles. On 20th June, the third estate representatives, they assembled in the hall of indoor tennis court in Versailles. In this to make, why they have met in this tennis court? Because to declare themselves as National Assembly and to draft a constitution to reduce, and that constitution they wanted to reduce the powers of monarch. So the indoor court, indoor tennis court, they had met on 20th June and they took an oath or swear that not to disperse till they had drafted a constitution for the France, for France. And the main aim of this constitution was to reduce the powers of the monarch. To reduce the powers of the monarch means the Louis XVI. So this was their aim. So what I have told that when they met in palace, in the assembly hall in palace, Louis XVI's palace, they walked out of the hall and again they met in a tennis court. They took oath that they should prepare a constitution, and till that preparing of constitution or drafting of constitution, they should not disperse. And the main aim of the constitution was to reduce the powers. And they were led by, these members were led by, or the leaders were Abbasius and Mirabeau. So these two persons were the members of this, or the leaders of this meeting, tennis court, oath and constitution, drafting the constitution work. So Abbasius and Mirabeau were the leaders. They were actually not from third estate. They were from second estate, or mainly from second estate. But they stood for the French people or third estate, because they had a very broad vision. So they had stood for the demands of third estate. Next, we have to see, during this preparation of constitution, France was facing many problems. What were the problems France had faced during this time, while one side preparation of constitution by this in the tennis court, while other side, entire France or the countryside, even the countryside France of France, people were facing various problems. The problems were that severe winter, and due to that severe winter, there was shortage of food. Severe winter destroyed the crops, and due to that crops harvest destroyed, food grains, there was more shortage for food grain, which increased the prices of bread. And to get bread, people were in queue in front of the bakeries. So that was one problem, that is the shortage of food. Another problem, that was king ordered troops to Paris and the storming of Bastille, or the destruction of Bastille prison. During this time, while we had discussed in the initial part of our first part of the French Revolution, we had discussed that how Bastille prison was destroyed, because the people, they were searching for ammunition, and one group of people, they went to Bastille prison because it stood for the despotism of the king, and that is why they went to the Bastille and they killed the officers in charge of Bastille prison and released the prisoners, and Bastille prison was stopped or it was destroyed. So king ordered troops to Paris and Bastille prison was stopped. One side it was going on. Once another, in the countryside, people attacked manor and chateaux. Manor and chateaux means the land of landlords, and the people, or the feudal people, palace of, or castle, or palace of feudal lords, it was known as chateaux and manor. These all were attacked by the French people. Tithes were abolished and lands owned by church were confiscated. Again, people abolished the tithe. Tithe means 1/10 of the agricultural produce. They have to pay to the church as tax, that was known as tithe. So tithe were abolished and lands were owned by churches were, or church were confiscated. Some land which was owned by the church, due to some people they don't pay the tax, so church took their land. Such type of lands were confiscated by the people. Tithe was abolished, the tax system which was abolished by the people. Again, many people, they attacked manor and chateaux. Many people, they went to storming of Bastille, that means Bastille prison was stormed or destroyed. Severe winter and shortage of food was there. So these all problems were going on one side, while the other side, some group of people, they were preparing, busy in preparation of constitution for France. This was the picture. And we could see king ordered troops. So Louis XVI ordered troops to Paris, those who were in protest and storming of Bastille, to repress them. King ordered the troops. So that was another arrangement done by Louis XVI while all these problems were happening. Then we could see the next, that France become a constitutional monarchy. Constitutional monarchy in the sense, monarch or king can rule, but he had to follow the constitution. So France at last did become a constitutional monarchy. The National Assembly, which met in Versailles in the tennis court or tennis court assembly hall, they completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. So the National Assembly, which I had told you that in the tennis court they met, they had completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. And they had reduced the powers of the monarch. They had reduced the powers of monarch, and these powers were distributed to three important organs, which even in India we follow, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. So this arrangement they have done. And they had also made the arrangement of voting system. That means voting, how they have made elections or voting system. Only men only can vote. More than that, men about 25 years. And another criteria, they have to pay the taxes equal to at least 3 days of laborer's wage. 3 days laborer's wage as taxes they have to pay to the government, and they should complete 25 years. Those people can vote. Means people, those who have less income of 3 days laborer's wage, they cannot pay, they cannot vote, and less than 25 years, they cannot vote. These people were known as active citizens. The active citizens had the voting right. And remaining all people, like below 25 years, men, people who own less than 3 days laborer's wage, and also women, they were known as passive citizens. They did not have voting right. So the constitutional monarchy, which was created by the French people, or the National Assembly, met in the tennis court. The voting system, that means 25 years more, 3 days laborers' wages they have to give. Such people were known as active citizens, and remaining all people were known as passive citizens. Passive citizens did not have voting right, while the active citizens have voting right. So these all became one of the important features of new France, which came to be known as constitutional monarchy. Or they have drafted the constitution according to the constitution. Voting system was made according to the constitution. Arrangement of power sharing, legislature, executive and judiciary, rather than concentration of powers in one hand, that is monarch. That system they had abolished. These all, which came to be known as a new system for the France.